Welcome, R. Johansson. Oh, I thought this was where we were gonna, never mind. I thought I was lifting the lockdown here. Okay. It's just R. Johansson's terminal. Okay, observation logs. Oh wow, there's quite a few. Compliance training parameters. Compliance testing phases. 1, data entry. 2, physical exertion mild. 3, physical exertion strenuous. 4, social exclusion. And 5, sanctioned violence. Wonderful. What are they trying to do? Create an army of these people or something? But they can't be controlled. Group SC, I'm thinking Spacer's Choice 1. Because they're a group from Spacer's Choice. How wonderful, the benefits you get being a Spacer's Choice employee. Initial testing, phase 1. Subject SC1A through K were given forms and phase one testing notes and writing implements instructed to fill them out to corporate standards. Upon completion, forms are placed into an employer-sanctioned shredding device by a technician. Test was then repeated. So they fill out the forms and they shred them. Do they people know they shred them? Volunteer 1D Kendall objected to further testing after completion of second set of forms. I guess, yeah, they see them shred them. Volunteer 1G after 5th. Volunteer 1B after 10th. No further objections from remaining volunteers. 1E Hobbs was discovered to be functionally illiterate and tagged for early advancement to the second phase of compliance testing. Objection from Volunteer 1D. Group SC5, initial testing phase 2. 5A through K were giving visual demonstration of multiple physical exercises. Note, thank you, testing assistant Lehman. Lemon? Then instructed to replicate them in accordance with verbal instructions. Observational notes. 5H complained of physical exhaustion after 5 minutes, missing numerous verbal cues. 5A, 5E, and 5K failed out at around the 15-minute mark. Test was terminated after 30 minutes as the technician became too hoarse to provide instruction. Group SC27, mid-stage testing phase 3. Subjects are instructed to follow a closed circuit around the perimeter of the testing chamber for the duration of the test. At random intervals, technician is to provide vocal cue to reverse course. Observational notes. Of the 8 test subjects remaining in group 27, 6 respond to vocal cues. Subject 63D became aggressive and was removed. 63B collapsed 30 minutes into the experiment and was removed. Remaining subjects exhibited compliance with all vocal cues for a remainder of experiment. Technician's addendum. Observational data compromised due to equipment failure. Technician Embry-S was found incapable of continued operation due to incessant weeping and was withdrawn, flagged for disciplinary measures. Oh, damn. Subject 63, late stage testing phase 4. Subjects are isolated and instructed to select one member of their experiment group for immediate removal from the volunteer program. Observational notes. Subject 63A, volunteer 63F. 63B is unresponsive for duration of testing session. 63C deliberates for 5 minutes 30 seconds before volunteering subject 63E. 63D is unable to recall the names and or identification numbers of her fellows, but has volunteered each of them in turn, citing immediate need for additional compound X injections. 63E subjects volunteers 63F. So two of them, 63F. And then B, C, E, D. Subject 63F refuses to comply with the instruction for duration of testing session. 63G exhibits confusion and extreme emotional distress, demands morning injection. Technician's addendum. Time as of previous note is 1400 hours. That's 2 p.m. for those not in the know. Subject exhibits extreme aggression. Subject terminated. Well, you're turning them into marauders, so they're all going to eventually have extreme aggression. Is that not the purpose of your testing here? Group 87, late stage testing phase 5. Subject is instructed to fire at shrouded target. One industry standard fashion modeling assistive device. Mannequin. Just call it a mannequin. Subject is not informed of nature of target. Observational notes. Subject has fired a target. Auditory reward initiated. Test reset. Subject has fired his observation window. Automated security enabled. Test reset. Subject has fired its other subject. Automated security enabled. Same. Fired a target. Auditory reward. Subject refuses to fire. And then two more times. Technicians addendum. Subject unresponsive. Test reset. Okay, and then messages. Incoming. There's quite a bit here. From Marion Blakesley, subject, safety reminder. This is a different one than what we read before, right? Okay. Yeah, because I don't remember this. In light of recent incidents, I'd like to remind you all that it's paramount that we follow the All Spacers Choice guidelines regarding safety and security. Yes, you will suffer professional and financial consequences if you are found to be responsible for damaging company property, but here in HIA, inattentiveness and recklessness also endanger highly limited company resources and threaten our overall production schedule. Think about what we are all here to achieve, then consider whether you want to be the one that lets us all down. Luckily, any and all injuries suffered by the volunteers this past week have been minor. All testing will proceed as scheduled. A reminder that all personnel are advised to report to the infirmary if they experience any symptoms listed on the notice LeBlanc provided earlier this month. It is strongly suggested that you use your allotted break to do this, as any losses to productivity will be reflected in your paycheck and or indentureship agreement. Just kill me before I ever work for any of these companies in, you know, Spacer's Choice, Rizzo's, Anticleo's, any of the others. I will accept death. It's horrible. From A. Ruane, subject, just a question. To R. Johansson. Hey, you and Andre talk about tossball sometimes, right? Have you noticed anything different about him lately? I'm pretty sure he's been at his desk all night. I was going to congratulate him on his newfound productivity, but I took a look at his reports just now, and some of them have very basic formatting errors. It's not like him at all. Maybe you could ask him about it? If something's wrong with its terminal, he should probably get it taken care of sooner or later. Or sooner rather than later. Angus Ruane. Observation room technician. From Marion Blakesley, subject resets. To all personnel. If we're going to meet OCI's figures this month, we'll need to double our testing capacity over the next few weeks. To that end, I need everyone in observation to work with disposal to halve the preparation time between tests. Have the volunteers exit at a jog if you have to. Just try not to let them see the bodies. And finally, from A. Hammond, subject Hey. Look, Embry lost his head because he couldn't keep up with the work. He was never going to amount to anything, and we all knew it. The surprise is that he lasted this long. I don't know why my reports are any of your business to begin with. But I know how to use a damn computer. I bet Weaver put you up to this. I've been working twice as hard as anyone else in this office this past month, and now she thinks I'm going to outpace her. But maybe it's simpler than that. These emails used to just be a nuisance. Now I'm starting to think maybe your loyalty is to some other corporation. Andre Hammond, observation room technician. And now, outgoing messages. To A. Hammond, subject, the boss. Hey, Andre, Dr. Blakesley started to come down here pretty often, usually for the morning shift. She hasn't said anything, just watches us go through the tests for a while, and then gets up and walks out. Weaver tried to give her a report, I think, but Blakesley gave her a look, and that was the end of it. You think we're doing something wrong? You tell me if you knew anything, right? I'll split my lunch with you again. Oh, and hey, great game last night, huh? Ricky Johansson. Yeah, these are all observation room technicians. And, oh, Victoria Sandoval. Subject, re-mantosaurs. Yeah, we're going to go back to mannequins for phase 5. None of the test subjects felt too torn up about shooting killer bugs from Monarch, I guess. Should make things easier for you over in disposal, right? The best part is that one of the cages didn't close properly last night, and a couple of little mantipillars got loose. Who knows where they are now? Morley had an absolute fit. I don't think he likes bugs. Ricky Johansson to Victoria Sandoval, observation room technician, blah, blah, blah. Okay, there's stairs apparently over there. And that's where we were. Jeez. Looks a lot dark. I guess that's tinted glass. Looks a lot darker.
Welcome volunteers to the combat testing.
Wish you'd stop that.
Under the guidance of the Spacer's Choice Technicians, we'll be completing a brief practice course. Volunteers are expected to follow all instructions without hesitation.
This is back to where we were? Okay.
Failure to do so.
Okay, so I've gotten all the phonographs. Return the phonographs to Roscoe. You found all the portable phonographs Roscoe needed to complete his employment contract. You can return them to him in the Sprat Shack. A woman named Georgie asked Roscoe to deliver the portable phonographs to her personal automac near Stellar Freighting. We have a choice of either one. Two, three, four, five. There are five. Georgie. Okay, so Roscoe. This is only one from Georgie, though. I'm going to return to Roscoe first and see if there's any. Maybe he won't take this one, because it's Georgie. You found an unexpected photograph in place of the one Roscoe described. I'll return to him first and see what's up. That's at the Gorgon mine, so I don't need to, yeah. Reach the administrative level. Keep up the terrible work. Why is this closed? Okay, can I get to the administrative level? It looks like maybe through here. I'm gonna try that. Shouldn't be anything over here. It sounds spooky though. This is where we came in. Well, that's where we came in. And then we went up there. And we've been around here. Small area here we have not been to, and we have not been here. Okay. Reach the administrative level. You've made it into Blakesley's office. The only thing left to do is send the override authorization signal. Well, first we'll probably get attacked by something. There's really nothing. There's gotta be things here. Supervisor. It's in there. Is this where the guy's gonna talk to us? It is way too tranquil up here. Reception. Oh, this goes out to the upper, doesn't it? The upper level. Seal, anyway. I thought I could open it for a second. Yeah, we're gonna have to pass by that video console. And the guy's gonna be there. Reception desk. Main menu. Welcome user N. Castillo? HIA visitation protocols. The Human Auditing and Inquiry Facility is a dedicated research facility and houses a considerable quantity of hazardous materials, machinery, and personnel. As such, no external visitors are to be permitted at any time, absent express written permission from HIA testing supervisor Dr. Marion Blakesley. If you suspect a visitor does not have the appropriate credentials, please observe the following procedures. 1. Stay calm. 2. Notify nearby security personnel of your suspicions. 3. Wait for security personnel and or equipment. Or mechanicals, right? And or equipment to finish disposing of the visitor. 4. Complete an incident report per official guidelines. Remember to use Spacer's Choice approved formatting and language. At no point should you leave your workstation unattended. Leaving your workstation unattended will be considered a severe security breach and may result in a fine and or summary termination of your employment with Spacer's Choice. Your supervisor has posted the following addendums. Right, that's the official stuff. If we do get visitors, inform me at once if they're from other departments. If it's Dr. Ambrose, don't get in her way, but log her every move. Really? If it's Clarence Mosley, keep him at reception. I'll come down in person to see this law-given miracle for myself. If Jasper Lowe or anyone else from Chem turns up, let them stew at reception. I'll send Assistant Morley down eventually. Messages. From Marion Blakesley's subject, HIA visit. Protocols update. HIA is on lockdown until further notice. Do not let anyone into the facility until the escape volunteers are located. I'm going to check volunteer induction for any sign of the fugitives. If you receive any keycard access notifications in the next 20 minutes, ignore them. Wow. Not want to work for this place. What's smoking here? Is it? Well, can I come up through here and we're... He's gonna talk to us. I just know it. Back into snake mode, because I'm gonna try these other doors before we go anywhere else. Before we head to our objective, anyway. Oh, damn it. Maybe we can get in there another way. Well, I wanted to check some other doors. We have that, if that's real. Maybe that will let me in that door. That's not real. Oh, B. Morley, the administrative assistant, I think, right? Oh, just messages. I thought I could open that door from here. Maybe her terminal inside. Who knows, that might be her bathroom or something. Incoming messages. Subject A, right? Not Arnold. Andre, I think? Ruin? Subject concerns... Angus, sorry. Re-concerns, actually. This isn't about a few volunteers, Morley. Most of Test Group SC-22A is already gone. Subject 17 is nonverbal, but we've had some luck using small amounts of the compound to coax him into the testing rooms. To be honest, some of the staff are starting to worry me, too. It's not just that ghoul in disposal, either. Weaver's convinced that the compound's getting into one of the ventilation systems somehow. Thought I just saw some ventilation going upstairs. I've caught her scrubbing her hands raw at the washing stations. I've tried reciting our safety protocols to her, but it hasn't seemed to help. I'm starting to think she might not be wrong. Angus Ruane, testing associate. For Marion Blakesley, subject condolence letters. Morley. Pick out two of the deceased test subjects and whip up condolence letters. Something saccharine and noble. Feel free to invent next of kin if there are none on record. Use the cheap paper. Nice. Leave the letters on the desk. I'll dispose of them shortly. Just gonna dispose of them. Then why bother writing anything? Outgoing messages. To all personnel, subject termination notice. From Morley B to all personnel. This notice is to inform all HIA staff that testing associate Angus Ruane is no longer a Spacer's Choice Pharmaceuticals employee, effective immediately. As valued members of the Spacer's Choice family, I trust that you will all pull together to shoulder Mr. Ruane's responsibilities in his place. I bet he was killed, huh? Assistant auditor. That's what he is. So wait, Ruane. He wrote this and then was terminated from employment and probably his life as well. Now, wonderful. To Marion Blakesley, subject incident report. Dr. Blakesley, the missing test subject has been found and apprehended. Apparently he got into the testing department where he remained. I'm afraid nobody noticed for several hours. Hennessy had him doing paperwork. I think it's clear at this point the subject SC-44B-12 didn't get out on his own. As far as we can tell, he didn't have much of an escape plan. The door is simply unlocked for a short period of time during the night. In the meantime, I've made it clear to the security forces that no further breaches will be tolerated. Mm-hmm. Okay, archive messages. From Marion Blakesley, subject, delete this. Well, you didn't take out your trash, did you? From Marion Blakesley to B. Morley. Morley, how do I delete this message? So the message is from Marion Blakesley to Clarence Mosley, subject, retesting group SCB4. Clarence. The latest results are in. As you hoped, you'll find that the violent cases now account for a smaller overall percentage of the testing pool. I expect that will change in about 2 or 3 weeks, so you'd better get that report out to Goodfellow in a hurry. In the meantime, dosing all the test subjects means that HIA is now in the business of generating aggressive psychotics. So if you could take 2 minutes out of your fundamentally pointless existence to consider to somehow make it clear to Mr. Goodfellow that I need an update on those resources I requested, as well as the matter of additional security, increased oversight at Chem, or any kind of explanation for what the beep. Alright, so she didn't save it. She wanted to delete it and didn't know how. Okay. And then hack deleted messages. From Marion Blakesley, subject readme. Morley, if you receive any communications from Dr. Ambrose, ignore them. Also, notify me at once. And don't piss yourself worrying. It won't come up on your assessments. From Marion Blakesley, subject read at once. Morley, no word from OCI. We'll keep going as we are. Say something to the staff. Break out that list of prepared statements I gave you. I suggest number 4. Remember to smile. I'm heading down to oversee today's testing personally. Make sure I'm not disturbed. Mm-hmm. Well then. Test design office. You shh.
Did you enjoy the show? I didn't.
Show, huh?
You should have left Gorgon in its grave, where it belongs.
Come from that?
Now I'm afraid I have to find a more permanent way to bring you down.
Come in.
Is it just me, or does it seem like our mysterious nemesis watches too many Aetherwave serials?
This is sick. I can't bear it any longer.
This place is gonna be swarming, isn't it? Shock and awe? I'm waiting for multiple red things to show up. Let me take a look at this. Actually, here. Clear this. Shock and awe. High volts, low amps. Or is it low volts? High amps. A nightmare for your enemies, either way. Especially if they're electricians. Really. Oh, broken data pad. Our first test group should be here in just a few hours. I suppose I should be catching up on sleep, but it's far more important to mark the occasion. I really think we can achieve something here. Every citizen of Halcyon wants to be of use, deep down. If this compound can restore industry and work ethic even to outlaws and miscreants, we won't need places like Tartarus anymore. Dissidents will be a thing of the past. Chem has sent over its first shipment of this mystery drug, and the testing chambers are operational. Once we've proven at our methods, it will be much easier to convince OCI to invest in better equipment. The remaining entries are inaccessible. So that's how it all started, huh? Not quiet so far. I didn't mean to lock him out. I just started to get panicked because things are going to come after us. How soon? And where? Anything up here? Alright, let's remove the lockdown. Welcome, M. Blakesley. Check out the messages first. At least I know while we're in this, right? Nothing attacks. At least that's the way it's always been. Hack 100. I think we can do it. That little symbol means that Max will be helping us do that. Incoming messages. From Olivia Ambrose, subject frequency of testing updates. Marion, it's been 3 weeks. Where the hell are the reports from HIA? Deliver them to me by the end of the day or deliver me your letter of resignation. I'm done asking. I like Olivia Ambrose and her daughter. They're pretty kick-ass. In the future, you will send me bi-weekly reports of HIA status. These reports will include... the only thing I didn't like is... I didn't like the way Olivia treated her daughter. It's obviously a horrible mother. Beyond horrible. These reports will include an inventory of test subjects, which version of the Gorgon compound they have been administered, how frequently those administrations have occurred, and who has been administering them. To these reports, you will append a mortality record. This record will include an accounting of the burn-down rate of our current stock of volunteers and compound ampules, in addition to a thorough analysis of their injuries. I want to see charts, Mary. Big charts with lots of precious little numbers. And before you ask, bi-weekly means twice a week. Don't pretend you don't know what I mean, Ollie. Bi-weekly. Doesn't bi-weekly mean every 2 weeks? Alright. Yeah, but she meant something else. I don't know if there's a... What would twice a week mean? Not bi-weekly. Oh. I don't know if there's a term for that. Incoming messages. From Olivia Ambrose. Subject, condolences, etc. Marion, personalize and forward the following note to the families of the deceased volunteers. Take carbon copies and send those on to Lucien at the usual address. Make certain he gets every single one, Ollie. Dear Name, it is with regret that I write to inform you of the death of your relation, Name. They died peacefully, attended by their fellows. Please accept our sympathies in this difficult time. Though it may offer you little comfort, know that your relation died in service of a better, more productive Halcyon. Surely then. In accordance with the agreement Name, signed with Tartarus Corrections, a division of United Defense Logistics, their term of incarceration is now considered complete. Sincerely, Dr. Olivia Ambrose, Project Director. You should really say something like, Dear Name, your relation Name, injecting dangerous chemicals, turned the person into an insane individual that had to be put down. Sincerely, Dr. Olivia Ambrose. That's what I should say. Alright. Outgoing messages. Quite a few. To Lawrence Goodfellow. Subject, latest results. Goodfellow. Yes, many of the subjects still exhibited increased energy levels and compliance. The same euphoric response, but they inevitably crash. Testing clearly suggests that Chem's compound X has extreme and irreversible effects when administered repeatedly over a long period of time. Several volunteers in the old SCO2 group are barely verbal. When they do speak, it's to beg for more of the compound. I'm finding it hard to shine that up for you, Lawrence. So good you'll beg for more? Don't you dare use that. He would. If we could dilute the compound or even ease out the schedule, we could mitigate some of the addictive effects. Weaning some of the earlier test subjects off the compound might buy us time until Chem refines the formula. Any time, Lawrence. To Benjamin Morley, subject testing reports. Morley, I need you to compile some of the test results from the past month. Pull a subset from the reports we've forwarded to OCI, if you like, so long as there are charts. Make sure the worst of the mortality reports are up front, will you? To testing lab, subject retesting group SC82. At the behest of the Office of Creative Incubation, we are applying varying amounts of unknown solutions to test subjects that are already mid-treatment. What organizational schema do you imagine would miraculously restore scientific rigor to this process? Stick to the current system. And finally, to Benjamin Morley's subject, condolence letters. Morley, pick out two of the deceased test subjects and whip up condolence letters. Something saccharine and we've read this on his terminal. Okay. Okay, archive messages. Subject L. Bancroft. Oh, 2 L. Bancroft. Subject resignation. Oh, Lucien Bancroft. Lucian, I'm leaving this message to inform you of my resignation from the position of testing supervisor of Spacer's Choice Pharmaceuticals, effective immediately. I won't be returning to headquarters, and I wouldn't bother chasing a tracking signal unless you want to give the boys and girls in human resource some exercise. I'll warn you once, do not try and find me. Dr. Marion Blakesley. No title or group affiliation. Okay, hack deleted messages. From Olivia Ambrose, subject recondolences, etc. Marion, cancel all the letters. If they've been hand-delivered, send someone to retrieve them. Secrecy trumps sentiment. Don't ever let me do anything so indulgent again, Ollie. From Olivia Ambrose, subject test, subject status. Marion, I see now why you held back your reports. Strangulation, attempted disemboweling, blunt force trauma to the head with a bedpan. It's not just that volunteer deaths are up, but the ways in which they're dying are appalling. This is unconscionable, an unmitigated disaster. Cease administration of the compound immediately. I'll take this to our liaison, Lucian. Surely when I show him these results, he'll understand that we can't take this product to market as it currently stands, Ollie. And yeah, this is delete this letter. How do I delete this message? Yeah, we read this on Morley's terminal. Okay, admin functions. Synthesis and manufacturing center status. Alert. Executive lockdown must be overridden in human inquiry and auditing, which we're currently standing. Synthesis and manufacture center is currently locked. Override SMC lockdown. SMC lockdown override sent.
I fear that I will become numb to these incessant horrors.